Hare Krishna. The choices you make, make you. All of us make choices constantly. And often we consider choices usually in external terms, in terms of having certain consequences. Say for example, if you're driving on a road and if you choose turn A or turn B, that has effects. No doubt about it. So we know choices have consequences. But how consequential our choices are, that's something which we often don't contemplate. The consequences are not just external, they're also internal. So if we choose to buy a particular product and we lose money by that, that's also a choice. And it has a consequence, we may lose some money. But along with all these external consequences, every choice has an internal consequence. So if we consider that, suppose we were building a house, then every choice we made, every brick we laid, every color of the wall or strength of the material that we are building, all of that would go into making our house. And that would be the house we have to live in. So actually, whenever we make choices in terms of our actions, at that time, those choices are like making our own inner house. Actually, the choices make us. What does it mean? Every choice is, it creates an impression within us. With every choice, we are building the inner house. Our inner house, if we consider ourselves to be the soul, then our subtle body, the mind, intelligence, ego, they comprise the inner house in which we live. Essentially, we can say our mind is the house in which we live. And if the house is leaky, if the house is wobbly, if the house is flimsy, then we will be endangered or at least inconvenienced amidst inclement weather. Similarly, if our mind is malformed, then it will hurt us. When life becomes tough, our mind will crumble and we will be in big trouble. Worse than that, actually, it's just as when the house crumbles, the storms outside are bad, but if we are inside a weak house, then we may be in greater danger than what would be inside the storm. And outside in the storm, in the storm we would just get wet or cold, but in the house the storm might, we might get crushed under the storm. So if we have made choices where, say, suppose somebody has repeatedly succumbed to some addictive habit, when life troubles them, then they overdrink, they take drugs or whatever, and then at the time of problems in life, when they take that indulgence at that time may cause even greater problem than the problem itself. Conversely, if someone has chosen to cultivate healthy habits and they keep cultivating those habits consistently, then they will grow by that, and they will grow in inner strength. It's like making your house very strong. And even if storms come externally, they will stay sheltered amidst those storms. So the Bhagavad Gita talks about how our inner world with its conceptions, our faith, that is shaped by us and then it shapes us. 17.3 says, Sattvanu Rupa Sarvasya Shraddha Bhavati Bharata Shraddha Mayoyam Purusho Yoyat Shraddha Sa Eva Saha. So here Krishna is talking about faith in the three modes of material nature, and he says the way we live, the kind of existence we have, sattvan rupa sarvasya, that means the kind of choices we do, choices we make, shraddha bhavati bharata, our faith, our conceptions get shaped accordingly. Shraddha mayoyam purusho, this as a person is essentially their house, in the sense that that's where if they get comfort and strength, then they are strong. Otherwise, if their home is in fire, then they cannot live peacefully. So we are essentially our inner conceptions. And yo yachraddasa eva saha, and as is our faith, so we will become. So thus, by understanding that our choices will make us, we can make those choices with great caution. Thank you. Hare Krishna.